As part of the concept of trying to keep a more greater sustain, it was determined around the 11th to 12th century in Spain that the best way that you could have a bow that didn't have to stop was that the bow was eternal. It was a circle. And that eventually led to this instrument, which is known as this originally as the organestrum, and then eventually became known as the symphonia. Modernly, it's known as the hurdy-gurdy. The instrument has a bowed instrument. It's much like a violin, but it's played in a slightly strange way. There's a wheel on the side of the instrument that is written here, that's turned with the crank. That acts like the bow of the instrument, that bows the strings inside. And there are three strings inside. One of them is called the chanter, kind of like on a bagpipe, the thing that you would finger. It is fingered by pressing these keys that touch the strings, much like your fingers stop them against a fingerboard. The other two strings are drones, and that fills out the sound and gives it a little bit more vibrance to the whole overall of the music. Originally, these instruments were huge. The organestrums were played by two people, one person cranking it and one person sitting about 4 feet away, pulling the stops. That was determined to be very, very impractical. And so the instruments got smaller and higher in pitch so that eventually they could become small like this on the lap. Eventually, by the Renaissance, they started to get a lot more complicated, and they ended up having more melody strings, more drones, and eventually a string called the chien, or the doggerel, that added a buzz sound to it so that you could add rhythm to it as well. Because unfortunately, with a continuous drone, you have no way of interrupting notes. That whole family of instruments kind of starts to lose favor by the Renaissance, because the music requires it to have drones, so it can only be in one key at the same time. Renaissance music starts to get a lot more complicated, so that this instrument falls out of favor. It can't play a lot of the music that was there. However, it still does see a slight resurgence in France in the 18th century with Marie Antoinette, who, unable to play the keyboard, found this one, which uses only one hand, to be much easier to play. And it became a popular court instrument there. Unfortunately, with the French Revolution, it kind of fell out of favor with the nobility, as they also fell out of favor. It only stays useful now, or as a common instrument now, in northern France, in an area called Brittany, and in some of the eastern countries, such as Ukraine and Hungary, which it's still a popular folk instrument. The piece I'm going to be doing from you is another piece from the Carmina Burana. This one is called, which is that group of 13th century Goliards, the students that wrote songs that were somewhat depraved. This particular one is about getting drunk in the tavern. It is called In Taberna.
Da burna quando sumis non good homage sedet humus sedet ludem proper homus ui semper in juda quide gator in da burna ubi semer en becerna hoc et hopus edura sui locus odiator. Quidem ludant, quidem vivant, quidem indiscretet vivant, sedet ludo qui morantur esquet quidem denudant, quidem ibat vanciantur, quidem sacis unduantur, ubet ibet temet mortem, sed pobacus medit stortem. Vivit hera, vivit heris, vivit miles, vivit claris, vivit ile, vivit ilas, vivit servus, comancila, vivit vegas, vigat, vigat, vivit halvas, vivit nigel, vivit constas, vivit vagus, vivit rudas, vivit magus.